Assalamualaikum students, hope you all will be fine. Students, you know that we are studying the sense organs and their functionality as we have studied the skin, tongue, nose. So today we are going to study the next sense organ, that is eye. Now what is the function of eye? Our eyes basically detect light and help us to see whatever in our surrounding. So these, we have two eyes and they are positioned so that each one gives a slightly different view of your surrounding, which means that they give us binocular vision. Binocular vision means that the two eyes are positioned in such a way that each one gives the different view, slightly different view of your surrounding. And obviously our eye produces the image or picture of what you're looking at. This information about the image from the eye is then sent to the brain. The brain then creates the three-dimensional picture of it. It also works out the size of an object and the distance from you. Like where is the object, what is the, is it farther away or the nearest to your eyes. So the brain see all these things. And we need two eyes because with only one eye, it would be difficult to judge the distance and the depth. That's why we say that eyes work on a binocular vision. Now, if we talk about its protection, so the eyelids cover the eye, the upper area of the eye, and then protect them from the damage. While our eyelashes, they flick away any dust approaching the eye, which means that when we blink our eyes, so they all the dust, they protect us from all the dust that can approach the eye or can cause the damage into the internal organs and the eye. Next is the tear glands. The tear glands, as they are name is indicating, they produce the tears. And when you blink this, the liquid, as it names a tear, is then spread over the surface of the eye. It wash the surface of the eye and stop it drawing out. So tears drain away through the tear ducts. As you can see in this picture, so this what all about the parts that can help us in the protection of eye. These are the eyebrows, and then here is the eyelid that protect the eye from damage. This the pinkish area is the tear glands that help us in the production of the tears that spread over when you blink the eye, so they spread over the surface of the eye. And these are your eyelashes. And here is the duct. This is the tear duct, and that open or ends in the opening into the nose. The next one is to see the structure of the eye. As you can see in this picture, page number 19, this is the parts of the eye or the microscopic view of the eye. The first one, that is called the cornea. As you can see, this transparent, this line, this is the cornea. Now, what is the function of the cornea? Cornea functions like window that controls and focuses the entry of light into the eye. As you can say that outermost layer, so it acts as the window, and that focuses the entry of light into the eye. The next one, as you can see here, this is the lens. So behind the cornea is a lens. So lens is basically elastic, and its thickness is controlled by the ciliary muscles. As you can see here, the two dots like image, these are called the ciliary muscles. In other words, it focuses the light rays that pass through it in order to create the clear image of object. The next one, the most important part, is called as retina. Now, what is the function of retina? Retina is basically a layer behind the cornea and the lens, where the image of an object is created as upside down. Basically, what happens when this eye sees an image? For example, when you see the tree, for example, like this in your surrounding. So when you see it, this image from the outside world is created in your retina, where the image is created. Remember that in the eye, the image of an object is created in retina. So it becomes like this, upside down. What happens then? The nerve impulses then go to the brain, and they ask from brain what they have seen. The brain then help to correct the image so that you see it properly. So it's just a game of seconds. You see image like this, but when it's created in the retina, it's like upside down. So that nerve impulse then go to your brain, and that impulses then come back from the brain and help the eye to see the image like this. The next one is the iris. Iris is the colored part of the brain. Here you can see this is the iris, and behind the lens, it's a sheet of muscle that is called the iris. It is the colored part of an eye. The next one is the pupil. Pupil is in the center of iris, as you can see here. In the center of the iris is a round hole that is called the pupil. Basically, what happens when you look at the bright light? So the iris muscles, they work to make the pupil smaller. This cut down the amount of light entering the eye, so protects the sensitive cells of the retina. So if you are in the dark room and the pupil then gets bigger to allow more light to enter into your eye. So the iris muscles work automatically in what is called as reflex action. Whenever something happens in the body parts automatically, that is called the reflex action. So these are some of the main parts that help us to see the image of our surrounding. These are the clear lens and with the ciliary muscles, cornea, iris, the colored part of the eye, retina, where the image is created, and optic nerves, that takes information to the brain and help to see the image in a correct way. So these are some of the parts of the eye. Now come to science workbook page number 9. As it is a question number 10. The diagram below shows a section through the human eye. Study the diagram and then answer the questions that follow. So here is the structure of eye with all the parts, and all we have to do is to solve this answer sheet on page number 9 of your science workbook. These are the following 5 parts about the eye. First one, what is the job or function of the pupil? So all we know that pupil is in the center or round hole, and it allows the light to enter into the eye. Number B, which part of the eye carries nerve impulses to the brain? So the nerve that are responsible for carrying the impulses to the brain are known as optic nerves. So optic nerves carry nerve impulses to the brain. C, what is the job or function of the ciliary muscles? So the function is to change the shape of lens and focus light on retina. D part, Name the two types of light sensitive cells in the retina. So there are two light sensitive cells, and as we have talked about when we are in the darkened room or when we see something in a very bright light. So the two very light sensitive cells that are responsible in the retina, that are named as rods and cones. Rods and cones are the light sensitive cells in the retina. E part, which three parts of the eye are transparent? Conjunctiva, cornea and lens are the transparent parts of the eye. So all you have to do is to bear in mind the concept of the functionality of the eye with its structures, and you have to solve this workbook science page number 9 with all these parts, and make sure to learn them as well. Thank you.